Hello, and welcome to my final legislative video update of the 2014 session. I'm Janaea Holmquist-Newbery, your senator for the 13th Legislative District. There is less than 1 week left in this session, and there is still much work left to be done. Budget leaders from both the Senate and the House come together to reconcile the varying proposals to produce one supplemental budget that can be agreed upon by both chambers and gain the governor's approval. It's a daunting task, but one I hope will be completed by the scheduled March 13th end of the regular session. As I mentioned in my previous update, several of the bills I've introduced are aimed at improving our state's business climate, improving our industrial insurance system, and making it easier for our employers to maintain and create new jobs. Unfortunately, one of the biggest obstacles to job creation in this state is the unwillingness of the Democrat leadership in the House to move on needed reforms. In fact, the House has become the graveyard where pro-job bills go to die. As I record this video, there are 2 days left and many of the job creation bills Senate Republicans have put forward are tied to the budget, so there is still hope. But the sad truth of the matter is that time is ticking away. Senate Republicans introduced 44 job bills this session, and as of today, the House has only passed one. You heard me right, only one of these measures. As the mom and pops out there still struggle to pay the bills and put food on their tables, House Democrats have put politics ahead of helping these families find the jobs they so desperately need. I will do everything in my power over the next 2 days to move these job proposals across the finish line. One of those bills that are technically still alive is my data center jobs bill. As you'll remember, Senate Bill 6550 would extend a highly successful tax incentive to technology firms willing to build data centers in Washington. It's a proven economic development tool that has benefited the entire state, but especially our rural communities. On Friday, the measure received a hearing in the House Finance Committee. The support for the bill was overwhelming and diverse. One of those testifying in support of the bill was John Sabe, president of Sabe Data Center Properties, one of the nation's largest privately held data center developers with facilities in Tukwila, Grant County, and Douglas County, as well as New York and Virginia. His testimony was direct and to the point. He stated, "We don't decide if the incentive is needed or enough, but our customers do make that decision. If their investment in Washington can't be competitive with other opportunities available in Oregon, Nevada, Iowa, or Virginia, they don't come here." He's exactly right. When Washington allowed the incentive to expire for a year in 2011, Oregon landed 6 major facilities. During that period, we lost out on hosting data centers for Facebook, Apple, Adobe, Amazon, among others. Microsoft also cut back on its plans for expansion in Washington and moved its servers to Texas, citing Washington's tax burden as the main reason for the move. By contrast, Patrick Boss, representing the Port of Quincy, testified to the success the port has had when this incentive was in place. And Quincy Mayor Jim Hemberry talked about how the property taxes paid by the data centers utilizing this incentive have proven critical to the growth of his city and have actually lowered property taxes for our citizens. My data center jobs bill also received broad support from the state's trade unions, which have benefited from the data center incentive, and they see the potential for more high-paying jobs being created for their members if the incentive is extended. Nicole Grant of Certified Electrical Workers of Washington testified that data centers are the main source of employment for her members, and that without this incentive, they just can't compete with Oregon. Terry Tilton and Jimmy Hahn from the Pacific Northwest Regional Council of Carpenters also testified in favor of the bill. Hahn testified that, and I quote, "Extending the incentive will encourage businesses to locate and expand operations in Washington and put our men and women to work doing what they do best. Those earned wages are then spent locally and help small businesses. It's a definite win-win." I couldn't agree more. Now, let's change gears to my efforts to protect you, your wallets, and your rights. As you know, I've spent my time in the legislature working to protect you from government that oversteps its bounds or attempts to trample on your liberties. Your rights are under constant attack, but as your legislator, it is my job to stand up for you and be your voice. Last week, I was called on to protect your rights once again. With less than an hour before Friday's deadline for the Senate to act on House bills, I urged my Senate colleagues to vote for a measure providing clear standards for the lawful use of drones by state and local jurisdictions. Now, drones can be a useful tool for law enforcement, but there are some serious concerns about how these unmanned vehicles are used, ranging from privacy violations to issues of liability and due process. These devices can hover in your yard, record inside your home, and use even infrared cameras to see through your walls. The bill I successfully fought for would require that these devices can only be used by state agencies or local law enforcement if there is prior legislative approval or a criminal warrant. It would also require that they be labeled in case one crashes or does damage to your property. It would have been irresponsible for us to allow yet another legislative session to pass without addressing the use of these devices in a substantial way. Fortunately, I was able to convince my colleagues to make House Bill 2789 the last bill taken up prior to the legislative deadline. The measure passed the Senate 46-1 and now goes to the governor. This bill is about protecting you, your constitutional rights, and personal privacy. Well, that's all the time I have for my video update this week. Again, this will be my last legislative update, as by the time you're watching this, the session will most likely have concluded. That means I will soon be home holding my district office days, meeting with many of you face to face. Check your mail in the next month or so for a full legislative update on how the session ended, as well as details on my district office days. In the meantime, please contact my office if you have any questions, concerns, or ideas you'd like to share. It has been one of the greatest honors of my life to serve you, the families, employers, and taxpayers of the 13th District. As you may have heard, I will not be returning to Olympia next session. But until the end of my term in January, I will still be your senator, and I'll still be fighting to protect you, your wallet, and your rights. I'm Janaea Holmquist-Newbery. God bless.